Rakeshwar Singh Manhas, a Central Reserve Police Force commando who went missing during a deadly encounter in Chhattisgarh last week, was released after 5 days in Maoist captivity, officials aware of the development said on Thursday. From Bastar, there is a good news for the nation, a police source said. According to him, Manhas was released in the presence of a social worker, Dharampal Saini, Gondwana Samaj Chief Gelam Boreya and hundreds of villagers. The 11-member team that was in talks with Maoists for Manhas's release also featured 7 local journalists, the source said. Sources also said that Manhas was brought to a camp in Tarem, the area where the encounter took place, and underwent health checkups. Hours before he was set free, Bastar Inspector General P. Sundar Raj told the media that efforts were on to secure his release and that the government was hopeful of positive developments. On Monday, a mystery caller had dialed local journalists to inform that Manhas, who is from the elite anti-Naxal Cobra unit, had been held captive by Maoist and that he will be released in 2 to 3 days. A Varanasi court on Thursday gave its approval for the survey of Kashi Vishwanath Temple and Gyan Vapi Mosque Complex by Archaeological Survey of India. The court further directed the Uttar Pradesh government to bear the cost of the survey. The court order came on a petition filed by a local lawyer V.S. Rastogi, who had demanded that the land entailing the Gyan Vapi Mosque be restored to Hindus. The petitioner claimed that Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb in 1664 pulled down a portion of the 2,000-year-old Kashi Vishwanath Temple to build a mosque in its place. The Gyan Vyapi Mosque Management Committee had opposed the petition. In 1998, Anjuman Intizamiya Committee moved the High Court contending that the dispute cannot be adjudicated by a civil court. The High Court did not pass an order in the matter and also did not stay the proceedings in the lower court. An independent probe is warranted in the matter of former Mumbai Police Commissioner Parambir Singh's corruption allegations against former Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh, since both occupied such high positions in the government, the Supreme Court today said. It refused to interfere with Bombay High Court order directing a CBI investigation into the charges, observing that the two persons involved were working closely until they fall apart. The comments from a Supreme Court bench of Justices S.K. Kaul and Hemant Gupta came on an appeal by the Maharashtra government and Mr. Deshmukh to stay the High Court order. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan tested positive for COVID-19 on Thursday. Sources say he is stable and is not having major health-related difficulties at present. On April 6th, the day Kerala went to polls, his daughter Veena had tested positive for COVID-19. Kerala has been witnessing a surge in COVID-19 cases for the past few weeks. On Wednesday, the state reported 3,502 new COVID-19 cases and 16 deaths. With this, the state's overall case tally has also risen to more than 11,44,000 and the death toll stands at more than 4,000. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee will skip the virtual meeting called by Prime Minister Narendra Modi today to discuss the COVID-19 situation with state chief ministers. Chief Secretary Alapan Bandopadhyay is likely to attend the meeting in place of the Chief Minister. Amid the second wave of coronavirus infections spreading in the country, Modi had called for a virtual meeting with state CMs to take the stock of the situation. The development also came amid a high-octane election campaign for assembly election in West Bengal. Earlier this week, the Prime Minister also chaired a high-level meeting to review the COVID vaccination program in the country.
Hello everyone. HW News English is 2 years old now. When we started this venture, we promised ourselves one thing, that news should remain free, because right to know is the right of every Indian. But to keep news free for everyone, we need support from some of you. And thus, we have rolled out membership on our YouTube channel, HW News English. But mind you, the membership is completely voluntary. The programs that we were doing earlier, that we are doing now, will continue to remain free.
First level is a basic level. Here, you can be our supporter by paying ₹199 per month. This membership gives you certain perks and benefits. The perks include unique badges in front of your name, a live show from Mr. Sujit Nair and from Mr. Akhilesh Bhargava per month for our members. You can also vote in some exclusive members-only polls. Now the second level is super supporter. Here you can be our super supporter by paying ₹3999 per month. This membership will include every perk that comes with basic level. Additionally, our super supporters can be a part of a WhatsApp group where we can have discussions and suggestions on various topics. The second perk includes a gift pack with our merchandise. And the third perk is a Google Meet with Mr. Sujit Nair, where you can join the meet and ask your questions to Mr. Nair face to face. Lastly, if you like, we would give a shout out to our super supporters in our programs.
So, hope to see you soon with our badges.